Item number, SCP-3104. Object class, safe. Special containment procedures. SCP-3104 is currently stored in evidence locker in the site B Sector Security Substation, pending investigation. It is to remain there until the investigation is complete, at which point appropriate measures will be taken. Description: SCP-3104 is an infohazard. It does not represent a hazard to Foundation interests, operations, or personnel if it is securely contained and information about it is not known to those outside the containment project. Access denied. Level 2 or lower clearance required. Confirmed. Risa Cognito Hazard Warning. Warning: the following information has been secured with a mild selective disabling cognitohazard by approval of the O5 Council, in order to prevent viewing and subsequent spread of an infohazard by Foundation personnel. It is designed to target Foundation personnel in the following departments: Internal Security, External Security, Internal Affairs, Administration, Records and Information Security Administration, Ethics Committee, O5 Council. If you have gained access to this information through unapproved means, please close this document immediately and report to your supervisor. Do not read further. Do not disclose any information to your supervisor other than that you have been exposed to cognitohazard RISA-3104 and require amnestics. If you do not have a supervisor, please consult Operational Manual RISA Cognitohazards, Procedures and Treatment for more information. Secure the help of a coworker if required, but do not disclose any information to them other than that you have been exposed. Special Containment Procedures. Foundation security personnel and anyone involved in administrative hierarchy above security are to be denied access to information regarding the nature of SCP-3104. This includes all administrative personnel from Level 3 to O5 level, as well as any Foundation Internal Affairs personnel, RISA personnel, anyone reported to by any of these departments, and others responsible for enforcing rules which Foundation personnel in general have to follow. This extends to anyone responsible for rulemaking where the rules affect groups of 25 or larger. Any Foundation employee in these departments exposed to information about SCP-3104 is to be immediately treated with a Class A amnestic. In the event SCP-3104 becomes relevant to site or Foundation security, as determined by the currently assigned junior researcher, information regarding it is to be sanitized by junior personnel with Level 2 clearance or lower, in accordance with standard Strict 7 Medium Infohazard Redaction regimes, and passed upward through the Infohazard Advisory Council. The internal affairs and security investigations are to be postponed indefinitely through informal means with the cooperation of the O5 Council and RISA by the way of the IAC. Evidence locker is to be locked with two locks, one of which has been internally welded shut. Breach containment procedures are to be devised, but such procedures are to be limited to containing the results of the breach and limiting public effects of the same. Procedures are not to mention the nature of SCP-3104, only the outcomes of its effects and how best to contain them. Information control filters are to be devised to filter any mention of SCP-3104 from police bulletins, law enforcement websites, and Interpol communications. Description: SCP-3104 is a brick of cocaine wrapped in plastic, ordinary in appearance, and weighing approximately 1 kilogram. It has no unusual physical characteristics, and testing has showed it to be identical in composition and effect to non-anomalous cocaine. On the plastic wrap is handwriting, possibly in permanent marker, reading 200X. SCP-3104 is an infohazard affecting those responsible in some way for law enforcement administration, and similar activities. If a person meeting this criteria learns about it in any way, including being told of the existence of the item or seeing any part of the item, they are compelled to obtain the item and place it in custody, and to spread information about it to other law enforcement personnel. Subjects affected by this compulsion only consider SCP-3104 to be in custody if it is secured in an evidence locker or similar arrangement belonging to the organization they are an employee of or have control over. This has the effect of causing complete disruption of law enforcement activity in the event of any knowledge of SCP-3104 reaching any law enforcement official. SCP-3104 was contained on 1980, following a widespread exposure event. Knowledge of the item first reached the Foundation when Foundation police liaisons in Florida received an all-points bulletin regarding SCP-3104, notifying police departments statewide of the existence of the item and stating that it was an extremely illegal fugitive from justice last seen in Tampa. A mass migration of law enforcement officers to Tampa ensued, including nearly all Foundation security personnel in the state exposed to the bulletin and not working in a sealed facility. Post-operation review of public media showed that police attention centered on the Tampa Drug Enforcement Administration field office, which was under siege by an extremely large crowd of police officers on foot and in police vehicles. Eventually, a breaching crew from the Orlando County Sheriff's Office arrived and managed to gain access to the building, at which point a crowd crush and melee ensued, resulting in fatalities and injuries. Several minutes later, MTF Delta 16, ordinarily responsible for the distraction and containment of SCP at site, the closest Foundation facility to Tampa, arrived on scene in a pair of M60A3 Patton main battle tanks, making their way to and through the front door of the DEA office and causing fatalities and injuries to police officers crushed by the tank treads, as well as Foundation fatalities, as SCP breached containment in their absence. Delta 16 secured the item and returned to site, followed by several hundred police cruisers, each filled to capacity, 5 police helicopters, 1 light-winged aircraft, and 20,654 police officers traveling on foot. Delta 16 then documented the item and placed it in evidence locker in the B Sector Security Substation in accordance with procedure, then entered debriefing room B3 to await standard debriefing. Site staff described the attitude of Delta 16 members at this time as jovial. Crowd control protocols at site were placed into effect immediately. The police cruisers arrived approximately simultaneously at the main entrance gate, eventually followed by stragglers over the next several days due to breakdowns and fuel exhaustion. The aircraft ran low on fuel and were forced to land. Amnestic fog canisters were used against the gathered law enforcement officers, removing the compulsion. The initial crowd dispersed on its own over the next several hours, with the Foundation providing tow service for those with disabled vehicles. It was determined during a debriefing interview that Delta 16 was not commanded by administration to secure SCP-3104. At that point, the Foundation at large had no awareness of it. An interview later determined that Delta 16 Epsilon, the loader for the number 2 tank, had a brother in the Drug Enforcement Administration, who had informed him of the seizure of the item during a routine family phone call. Automated monitoring did not flag the call. At that point, Epsilon informed his squadmates. The MTF then manned their tanks and exited the site through a closed gate. Security forces were alerted and prepared to mount a counterforce or retrieval operation of sufficient strength to counter the tanks, assuming that Delta 16 had gone rogue or been otherwise compromised. By the time Delta 16 took control of the item and radioed that they were returning to base, the Foundation forces had reached the outskirts of Tampa. Rapid deployment operations at site were reviewed and revised following this incident. After researcher evaluation of the info-hazardous effects of SCP-3104 and its effect on the internal affairs officer initially responsible for the debriefing, Delta 16 and the officer were treated using the debriefing room's built-in amnestic foggers. Delta 16 has been cleared of all wrongdoing regarding this incident. The crowd of officers proceeding without vehicles continued to arrive over the next several days in taxicabs, commandeered cars, and eventually on foot, having walked the entire distance. Amnestization procedures were performed on each as they arrived, and they were assisted with return to their homes and medical treatment where applicable, placing a temporary strain on site its medical department, and motor pool. A disinformation campaign was enacted regarding a police union march and unrelated crime wave in order to explain the Tampa event and the effects of partial or complete absence of police presence throughout a large portion of Florida. Thank you guys so much for watching, and a huge thank you to all of my patrons on Patreon. Special shout out to my level 4 patrons, Alexis, Zagreat, and Ryan. If you would like to see your name at the end of my videos, see my videos early, and get some other cool perks, head on over to patreon.com/drmaxwell. Link in the description.